Hey guys, it's me, Lilac Rose, and I am here to do my comparison review of my two Ariel dolls that came out in 2013 and in 2019. yes, I'm so excited to get this review going. This is my first time comparing two of my dolls. I've never done this before. There are other videos up there that did them a while back ago, but I wanted to take my time. I'm not in a rush to do things. So don't forget to, since you're already in my channel, don't forget to subscribe since you're already in here. Also hit that bell notification so you are notified every time I upload a video. And yeah, just share, comment, and thanks for joining me in my channel again. Before we get down to this review, I definitely want to show you guys all details from everything. But so yeah, thank you guys so much for joining my channel. Let's get ready to roll that clip so we can start doing this review of these Ariel dolls. We did. Hey guys, so I am back here with my channel, and I am here with both of my Ariel dolls. I am so excited to have two of them. I actually got this one back in 2017 or 18. I'm not too sure. There is a video of me doing that video. I will definitely leave it in the link bottom below. The same for this one as well. I got this one last year. This one was released last year around November, December. I was just excited to have them. The only reason why I ended up with two Ariels is because I didn't know they were ever going to come out with Ariel again. So I saved up so much money to finally get the original Ariel. This one cost me about $400 or $300 because I had got her on eBay. Not eBay, I got her on Facebook. My first time ever buying a doll on Facebook. I was scared. It was my very first time. I thought I was going to get scammed. I did it through PayPal. Of course, always do through PayPal. Never want to use your credit card buying anything online. If you have that option to use PayPal, I would use PayPal. Yes, she's just gorgeous from head to toe. She came out in 2013. I really like the classic square boxes. Now they moved on to the live action kind of puffed boxes, but I really like this too because I feel like they can put more design on this than they can this. Back then it was just plain white, but I can see by the two Ariels that they are totally different. One says a Disney store and this one does too, but you can hardly see it. It's like all the way up here because it has all the metallic effects. I think they're both beautiful in design, so I'm gonna turn them sideways that they both have like a different design to them. They're both giving me that kind of underwater theme. Really nice. They did do some more land aerial ones, but they were more released for D23 and the Platinum set. Now the thing about the D23 one, the pink Ariel dress, I really wanted that one. I really, really, really wanted that one, but it was between her or Vanessa, and I really wanted Vanessa, and I had to get Vanessa, which I will bring Vanessa in later. But here's the descriptions. This one is the very first Little Mermaid Ariel doll, which a lot of the older ones came with like more than one language, which is insane. You had French and Spanish and Italian and probably all kinds of other languages, and of course English. And the newer ones, all you get is English and French. So as I go down, you can see there's more seashells and bubbles, and it's a certificate of authenticity and display stand included. The new one does not say that. The new ones also do not have the price anymore, for the simple fact is that these dolls are getting flipped a lot, and Disney wanted to make a profit off of this as well. Since they, you know, they're raising up the prices, they wanted to raise their prices as well. That's why they don't add the price on here no more. But the original prices used to be $100. Could you believe that? I still have the original sticker on here for Ariel, and in Canada it was $109. They're not $100 anymore. When I first started collecting, they were $120. Now they're $130. So they go up in price $10. So you know what? It's okay. Here we have another side view of Ariel, and we're going to check out this side view of this Ariel. And I think it's just pretty with all these colorful effects you have on this Ariel. Then you have just the plain white on this Ariel with the blue embroidered around here. It's really nice. And the top thing about this Ariel is that you can put more details on here. And it has the ribbons, of course. And this one was just plain white with more of that aqua marine embroidery. So let's actually get inside these Ariels and check them out. Okay, guys. So I am back here with both of my Ariels. I know it looks like that one of them is taller than the other one. It's not. I have to actually lean the older Ariel because she's so heavy. Her front body is too much this way that when I do lean her properly, she looks really low down and she might fall, and I don't really want to damage her. So that's why I have her displayed like that downwards. Before I get into reviewing both of these dolls and comparing them, I actually wanted to compare their certificates of authenticity. So here's what they look like. Not much has really changed. The plastic and the cardboard quality has changed. The newer ones have thicker plastic and thicker cardboard. The older ones have like a really cheap flimsy cardboard with a really cheaply made plastic. Yeah, these are like the older ones. Really nice designs. The back is still kind of the same. It has multiple languages. The newer ones don't. I don't know why they just went to two languages, to French and English. But here is the back. And a lot of people like to take their certificates like this. Like, we don't know. You don't have number one out of 5,500 when you turn it around this way. That's how you know which number you have. So a lot of people like to play that game, like, oh, I have number one, but no. And on this older Ariel, I have 889, which is a pretty low number. Yes, it's really low from the newer one. There was actually more of her made, the original one, 600, and there was only 5,500 of the newer one made. This doll is 7 years old. It's really old. So this one is actually a year old. Not too old, but they are kind of old. It's like every time I shoot a video, I have a sore throat. I'm still sick from COVID, you guys, so just take it serious, please. As we look at both Ariels, they do have really different faces. You can tell that the older one has more of a longer face and the newer one is more rounded. I do like the newer face more than the older ones because the older one looks more mature, like an older Ariel, and the newer one looks like she's more younger, like she's actually her age. The newer one is just more movie accurate than the older one was. The older one is more fashionalizable. A lot of people did not like these scale thingies, but I actually love this. I think it gives it more of a couture look, and especially with the seashell belt and this right here. These are so cute with little seashells and pearls. I think this design is really beautiful than the movie accurate one, but so many people wanted a movie accurate one. I don't know why. It's supposed to be a limited edition doll. They're supposed to be different. They're supposed to be more luxurious than what they are, but then people complain that there's not enough embroidery, that there's not enough gems, that there's not enough this. They were mad because Ariel has this. Well, they had to make it different than the movie. If you take this away, then it's pretty much just a regular doll that you can buy at the store that has sequins and a pretty bra. But I know the Japanese version of this Ariel had pearls because they can't have these little glass beads because of child protection laws that they have there are way different. Their hair color is exactly the same. This newer Ariel has pearls and a flower in it. I really like that from the newer version than the older one. The older one has like this star on her head. Sorry, like I said, she's very heavy. This one is very, very heavy, probably because how they pose there, but this one has like a sea star on her head. She does have rooted eyelashes, just like the newer one, of course. She has lighter makeup, so, and a lot of people were mad because they didn't give her a swirl. That's why a lot of people are upset, because she didn't have a swirl. The newer one, they actually gave her little flip swirl, where she, I don't know, people were crazy about that, but it first appeared on Meg, and they finally gave it to this newer Ariel. The older one and the newer one still have that kind of like wiring tail. It does have a lot of sequins and gems on here. Well, sequins on the tail. It has a lot of gems on here. I think the older one had a thicker kind of fabric or thicker kind of embroidery, but it is a lot more thicker than the newer one, and it is darker than the newer one. The newer one is just, it stands out a little bit more movie accurate, and I know a lot of people who missed out on the original one started collecting later, and they finally got the newer one, so they were happy about that. I do enjoy both Ariels. There's not much for me to say because their jewelry is different as well. This one has like a actual fish bracelet, and these ones have like little bracelets and little necklace ties. I think the design really kind of lowered to me personally, because I feel like this is more of a luxury doll, and this one's more of a classic doll that you can find at the Disney store. But they just gave it rooted eyelashes and pearls in a stand. The stands are still the same. This one's just thicker than that one, than this one is. I don't like the pose how they did on this one, for the simple fact that she is too heavy and she leans down and it'll fall. But when you put her in the box, she's just like right side up. But that's the only reason I don't like this pose. Other than that, I really enjoyed this Ariel, this newer one. So honestly, my favorite one out of both of them would have to be the newer one, because it is movie accurate, and I just like the fact that, honestly, I like both of them really, because I work really hard to get what I can get. The older one, I love its outfit, but I like the newer one's mold. That's, if I can switch them, I would, because it just looks more luxurious. It looks more limited edition doll to me than this one does. You guys might have a different comparison than I might, but that's just how I feel. If I can switch their outfits, I would. That's the only thing I would do, because I think this one is more limited edition worthy than this one is. The only thing that's giving me limited edition worthy about this doll is the chains and the pearls. That's pretty much it. And maybe the flowers and the beads in her hair. Other than that, I think this is really couture. This is giving me shells. This is giving me pearls. This is giving me dangles. This is giving me belt. This is giving me each sequin petal on here sewn with gems on them. I think that is so crafty to make it look like moss, to make it look like she's under the ocean, like she's been under there for so long. But there were so many complaints. I mean, so many complaints, and people are still complaining. If I had both of their Rapunzel dolls, I would be comparing them like I'm doing Ariel. There were so many complaints about that too. There were so many complaints about Tiana when she came out. There were so many complaints about every single doll that gets re-released. And it's just, it's insane. I'm just happy that I was able to get two Ariels and I just have one. Like I said, I originally got her for $300. I got her at the Disney store for original price. I try to get my dolls as soon as they come out in the Disney store, because I don't fuck with eBay, for the simple fact that they keep raising up the prices every single time. Now they're just starting at $400. Like, not even giving it $100 to $200 limit like they used to. Probably because we're in a pandemic, I don't know. But Rapunzel's going for $400 to $500, and soon she'll be to $1,000. So I am so happy that I at least have one Rapunzel that I can, you know, enjoy. But yeah, it's just insane how some of these dolls are going. I do really love my collection. My collection has really grown twice as much as when I first started in 2014 or 16, one of them. I'm just excited to have more videos for you guys, more content. I'm sorry I haven't been really uploading. I really haven't been feeling well because of COVID and everything that's going on, and it's snowing now. But yes, I'm so excited to have both of my Ariels. I really hope you like this little comparison review. I really enjoy both Ariels. I hope you guys were able to pick up one of them. They are both no longer available on the Disney store. Of course not. You have to get them off of eBay. I'm so sorry. If I was you, I would look at whichever one is cheaper. I really want to open this one because I have this one. But you know what? I like the older one too, so I really want to keep her as much in the box as possible. This doll, for being in the box, it has been 7 years she's been in a box. Really long time. And this doll has been in the box for a year. Now, you guys know that I just recently got Tiana, and then I recently just got Rapunzel. And I have them both on my vanity because they're one of my top favorite ones right now. The rest of my collection is honestly up here, and then I have some in my living room, and then there's some behind me as well. If you guys want to look at my whole limited edition doll collection, let me know in the description. Say, like, yeah, we want to see your whole collection, like I did with my anime DVDs. They're all behind me. So yeah, I do have dolls behind me. I do have some in the living room. I do have some on top of my shelf because I'm running out of room. But you can never stop buying dolls. So let me put them back in the box and bring out Vanessa. Alright guys, so I'm back here with all three of my dolls. I do have a review for each of them, and I will put them in the description below. Like I said, I got Vanessa. I didn't get her at D23 because I can't afford to go all the way to California to pick up a doll. And a lot of people said it's just more easier just to buy them off the people than actually go there and, you know, stand in line for 20 hours and at 2 in the morning, which is ridiculous. It's, I heard the struggle. And if you're just going just to get dolls, it's not even worth it. Just buy them off somebody. So I did get the D23 Vanessa because I did miss the Disney store Vanessa, which I was so upset. Oh my god, I literally cried because I wanted this doll so badly, so badly. And I was just like, you know what, I better get her now before she's $1,000. And she's $1,000 now. I got her last year when she was released about a month or two. I was like, I'm going to get her now. I don't care which one I get. And I saw this D23 one somebody was selling for $400, and I was like, you know what, whatever, I'm just gonna buy it because this is probably the lowest I'm gonna get her at. And I was thankfully I did get her early because now she's going for $1,000, and I really want that pink dress Ariel, and that one's going for like $1,000 to $2,000, which is ridiculous. I think it's so ridiculous. Same for that platinum set. I really want that Ariel and Prince Philip platinum set so bad, but I can't afford everything myself. I do everything myself, and not only that, I collect anime. Anime can be just as expensive as these Disney dolls can, and I spent some money on these dolls. It's been ridiculous. You know what? What's funny is that the D23 one is less love than the Disney Store one. The Disney Store one is actually more rare, which I don't understand, because that one had 2,000. This one has 1,000, and it's a D23 one, which you can only get at D23. This was my very first D23 item. My very second D23 item was the Prince Naveen and Tiana set that came out that same year as this one did, that you can only get at D23, but they were selling it at the Disney store, which I was kind of amazed. So I picked that one up. One thing about the newer ones and the older ones, that the hand molds definitely changed, the body definitely changed, because they have articulation right here. So do they right there, but you can bend them more. I think these ones you can only do the splits, I'm not too sure, but these ones are different as well. Their bodies have changed over time, definitely for sure. They're more poseable. The arms have changed as well. How you can only go so far with the arms, now you can go even higher with the newer arms. The wrists kind of changed. The hand molds are definitely changed, like I said. Yes, I think I just love them. So this is my little mermaid collection that I have right here. This is the only thing that I have. If I can try to get the platinum set, the Ariel and the pink dress and other ones, I'd be so grateful. But you know, like I said, it's just me by myself. And the funny thing is, I was working on getting the platinum set with a seller on that actually lives here too, and she was going to sell it for me for $1,500, and I was so close. I had like $800 already saved, and we were going to meet up and we were going to just trade, but Corona happened, and I had to leave my job, and I told her I couldn't afford it anymore because I wasn't bringing in any more income. I had to pay my rent. It was either a rent or a doll, and I can't live on the streets with a whole bunch of dolls, so I had to pay my rent. And And I tried contacting her again a few months later, and she never responded, so I guess she already sold it. And I told her, if you're going to sell it, go ahead. I can't stop you from making your money. So she probably already sold it, and I was upset. I was really bummed out. I really wanted that platinum set so badly, and I tried to save for it, and I tried to get it when it originally came out, but I couldn't afford it because I still had to pay bills, and it's just hard doing it by myself. I'm not like these other YouTubers that have, you know, partners and loved ones that can help them. You know, I do it on my own. And then I have so many collections. I have the castle collections that I need to finish. Rapunzel's castle sold out, so now I gotta try to find that. I don't even think I'm gonna complete that collection. It's ridiculous. Then we have the it's just the Mickey and Minnie's memory collections that I didn't finish because of COVID, and I wasn't picked for any of them, and I was just getting, I gave up on that collection too. So yeah, I'm gonna go back to collecting anime a lot more. I need to start collecting more figures, but then again, it's hard collecting figures too because they can get so expensive, and then my cats love to break them, so I have them in high places. It's just, I can never win. So it's been a really tough year. So when I got this D23 Vanessa, I was very grateful to even have one because I missed out on the D23 one, and I missed out on the Disney Store one. So I'll take the D23 one for whatever price that person was selling at. I'm so grateful that I got it early. And when D23 rolls around again and I don't go, I'm definitely going to buy them as soon as possible. I don't care if they're $400, $500, because the simple fact that those D23 ones will be $1,000 in a few more months. So I'm just going to get them as fast as I can. And yeah, I'm going to be prepared. And I know when D23 comes around, so I'm already saving money. Because I just want to get as much dolls as I can and anime and stuff to keep my YouTube going. But yeah, look at me, ran around talking, and yeah, it's just, I'm so excited to have this collection. Thank you guys so much for joining me on my channel today. It's been a long fucking year. I'm glad dolls are over with. I ordered some stuff off of Right Stuff, and I ordered some stuff off of Sentai Filmworks. I'm waiting for that to come in so I can do some anime unboxings. I will have, hopefully, I know I said this yesterday, but I will try to have an anime music video every single day next week. I kind of know what I want to go, what songs I want to use. But if you have any anime preferences, leave them in the description on this video below. It really helps. And thank you guys so much for joining me on my channel today. Have a happy holidays. Be safe. Please wear your mask. And we're going to get through this together. There is a vaccination going around. But you know what? That can only help so many people. So see you guys later on the next video. Bye.